Well, good morning. It's Long Haul Tanker, straight razor shaving with Long Haul Tanker. And today is Friday, the 7th of April, 2023 at approximately 12:15 p.m. Central Time. Coming to you from my home, master bathroom here where I sometimes am when I'm not on the road. I'll tell you more about that as I progress on here. And so just had a nice hot shower and gave myself a haircut. And I've got about 48 hours of growth on my face. I had a shave Wednesday off camera and a shave Wednesday, Tuesday. I think I did that one on camera. Sunday off camera. So there we are. Let's go over the equipment for this morning. First, however, let me say if you're joining me on YouTube, I say thank you and appreciate y'all being here. Hit the like and subscribe button and leave a comment if you so wish. And then go on over to The Shaving Cadre at www.theshavingcadre.com and join in the forum, join in the conversation. And there's always something going on over there, either serious about razors and brushes and soaps and so forth and shaving, or something far less serious, like who sleeps during the Zoom calls. I don't have any idea. Anyway, visit the member channels that produce shaving content. Handle Barber Dave, Major Rich, Nurse Dave, Bill M, The Cutthroat Journey, Shooting the Shave, Spider Shaves, the Luxury Shaving. I always get this one wrong, but you'll find them in the description below. Martin Shaves, and last but not least, Lukey 3262, also known as Matt. And you'll enjoy their content. So the equipment for the morning, afternoon, I've got a new razor. And it's a vintage. And it is Simmons Howe Company. Simmons Hardware Company, USA. And on the front, it says Barber's Pet, gives a number 421. And it's about 5/8, nicely done. It's in very excellent condition. I was going to say near mint, but it's got some scratches on the toe. And that doesn't, in my mind, qualify as near mint. But it is an excellent condition. And I'll say more about the razor as we go on. It's got excellent, I'm going to say they're plastic, acrylic scales, but they're in excellent shape. They are well formed and fashioned, and I like it very much. So I spent a good deal of time on this, setting the bevel. And I'll tell you why, and you won't be able to see it now, hopefully, but up here on the toe, about my finger, just in about a quarter inch or so, there was a bit of a chip on the edge, about the width of the bevel, and which means I'm going to take off some steel to retract the bevel, the depth of the chip. And so, but I did without destroying the profile of it. It still looks pretty straight, but there is a chip that has been honed out. I use the Shaft and Glass Stone 500 rather vigorously to get that out, and brought it up on the Shaft and Glass progression 1,000, 2,000, 4,000, 8,000, and 16,000, notwithstanding Dr. Mant's review of the Shaft and Glass 16,000, but I used it And then I fell back to the Belgian codicil and finished it with a Belgian codicil. Now, I have two 8x3 Belgian codicils. I have my, what I call my A codicil and my B codicil. And over the years, my B codicil has not gotten much use, more so out of neglect than any other reason. And so, and I may have another razor in my collection that was honed up on the B codicil. I just don't recall which one, or if at all. But the Simmons Barber's Pet, I can definitely say, was honed up on my B codicil. And we'll see how it performs this morning. What else was I going to say about that? My soap this morning is Martin DeCondre Agrumes, which means citrus, as I understand it. I do not have it soaking in water, so I will be lathering from it dry. And then using the Plasson number 20, 30 millimeter High Mountain White set in natural horn. And it's just a beautiful, beautiful brush. And love it very much. And so I'm going to lay into it. And while I'm lathering up, I'll tell you a little bit more about what's coming up for me. And we got in last Friday night, spent the night on the yard a week ago today. So today is day number seven, as I'm counting. Day number seven at home. I came home, I laid over on the yard, came home Saturday morning, and called in yesterday. Well, actually, I called in on Wednesday morning, got a hold of one of the new dispatchers who doesn't really know me and my preferences. And I asked for the other guy, and he said, no, he's not here yet. He'll be in this afternoon. The guy that I know and have worked with for years, who knows my preferences and so forth. And so I was going to call back Wednesday afternoon after the gentleman's name is Joseph, after Joseph got in. And, but I failed to do so, more out of laziness than anything else. And my wife said, are you going to call Joseph? I said, nah. I said, if they got a load that fits my criteria, Joseph knows to call me, which is extra long and Canada, extra long or Canada, 1500 miles plus or better. And so they know to call me. And so I didn't press. My wife was a little annoyed at me that I didn't call. But I called yesterday morning because I knew Joseph was going to be on duty. And he told me, informed me that we are very, very slow. And I said, well, what do you got coming up by way of Canada? When's your next Calgary run? And he looked on the schedule. And he said, our next Calgary run, it doesn't load until next Thursday, which is a little unusual. I said, you got anything else? It's 1,500 miles plus. And he's looking, did a sort. He did a query on the system. And there wasn't anything else. That was 1,500, 1,200. It's all local, 800, 400. Stuff to Dallas, local stuff in Houston. And I said, there's nothing. Nope, there isn't anything. So think about that for a second, folks. all of the petrochemical plants that are here in the South Texas, Houston, Southeast Texas, all the chemical plants that we service, which are the big names. If I said the names, you'd immediately recognize them. Not much is going out. And especially the extra long stuff that we normally service. I'm actually quite excited to use this razor, of course, any new razor for the first time. I've not yet used this razor at all. Got a nice hydrated lather. Whoops, just spit soap everywhere. I think we'll go with that. So I will be home for another several days. They'll get the load preloaded using a preload driver. So they'll bring it back to the load, a yard loaded for me. And depending upon what time of day they bring it back, what time it loads, what time they bring it back, I may not get out of here until next Friday morning. All right, Simmons Hardware, Barber's Pet, number 421, here we go. Let's see how caudical, my B caudical works. The first strokes are pretty good. As I descend on down, still performing fine, as expected actually. I'm keeping the razor pretty flat as I come across. And that's just fine. Just fine. This razor was found on eBay by my good friend Lukey3262, Matt, and sent me the link. And it was a buy me now situation, and he had it up there for about $30. And you know, for that price, a near mint condition, an excellent condition, you can't beat it. And so I snatched it up real quick. Yeah, I don't have a lot to say today. Just been home, relaxing, enjoying my wife's company and eating her cooking, which I love to do. She loves to cook, I love to eat. It's a very mutual relationship. My wife is working from home today, as she does every day, and she's back in the office, our home office, and she's not expecting to have a very heavy, busy day today, so we like to watch television. We're old people. We like to watch, binge watch on the series. We subscribe to Hulu and Amazon Prime and Showtime and Paramount Plus. We do not subscribe to a full-on cable company, so we stream everything. doing a fine job. Smooth, comfortable, as codicils are known for. And it's not maybe as quite as crisp as a full-on synthetic 20, 30,000 or a Arkansas. And who knows, maybe I'll play with it for a while and move it back and forth. But I certainly wanted to get a feel for my B codicil. And it's doing fine. I have no complaints on how it's actually doing. we're having a blustery weekend. It's supposed to rain all day. It rained all last night. Had some severe thunderstorms through the night. All right, let's move along. Razor's doing fine. Let's do a little hand stropping just to help things along. coming along just fine, I should say. If I didn't say it before, you probably may have guessed that this 5/8. Oh, by the way, on the box it says clean cutter. So the connection of the names is always something. We got clean cutter, we got Simmons Hardware, we've got Barber's Pet. All three names connected with this razor, but it's very lightweight. Very lightweight. It's almost amazing how lightweight it is. the soap is doing a marvelous job, but who can ever question Martin DeCondre, right? Excellent soap. Begins to dry up a little bit over here, so we'll just rehydrate with a little water and get it well mixed in. And the brush is just doing a, you know, as you would expect a brush of this caliber to do. High Mountain White, 30 millimeter. Poisson. Natural Horn. Beautiful razor. Brush. Right. Moving on to pass number three, against the grain, upstroke, south to north. All right, I think that's about it. That is about it. Let's move on to the head shave. And I'm going to use the same razor, Simmons Hardware, Barber's Pet, for the head shave.
Put the lid back on the jar.
as I said, I had a haircut before the shave this morning, and so my hair is very short, hard to see, so I'm going to wait till it, you know, 2 or 3 days before I trim that up. Put the brush down in the water, let it start soaking, dissolving the soap, getting it ready to clean after the shave. And I'll run some more hot water a little bit later. We're about done anyway. I'm just going to do the back of my neck and we'll be done. Ooh, hour and a half. It's all right. I'm at home. All right, that feels pretty good. Yep, we'll call it quits right there. Well, not quits. We're done with the head shave. We're done with the face shave. I got one more section, and that's the refinements. We got to do the refinements. So I'm wiping off the clean cutter. See if I can get a good Simmons Hardware Company. Bottom line says USA. Second word of the second line says distributors, I think. Can't read the first one. First word of the second line. And then on the front side, let's see, is that, I don't see that clearly. It says Barber's Pet, number, top line says number 421. Second line says Barber's Pet. So there's that. 5/8, just in excellent condition. Got the chip out of the front by the toe yesterday. Came in the day before yesterday. Thanks, Matt, for the tip. It's a great razor. I'm not sure I'm going to leave the Cotical B edge. May switch over to a one of the Arkansas edges. Hard black, translucent, true hard. And I might do that on camera. I don't know. Don't know. All right, so let's do the refinements. Let's do a cold water rinse. We're going to use the Osma Allen block. And as they say, there's no real cold water in Texas. Not like there is up north during the winter and early spring, I'll tell you, coming back from that last Calgary trip. So there's the Allen block. Got a little chip left from a previous stone. All right, let's wipe that off. All right, drain the water on the sink. Gonna run up some hot water. In the meantime, let's apply some Thayer's lavender. We got some Lucky Tiger, and as I like to say, because I want to, got a nice citrus scent to it, and what better after Martin DeCondre Agrumes. Thank you. giving a chance for the face to dry. Okay. We got some Florida water here, a nice little aftershave. Very, very fresh scent, very, you might even say, oceanic scent. Put a little more on the back of the neck, back top of the head. Finish on the face again. And we're going to finish with the Clubman. Got my little brush here. Do a powder bomb. I'm going to have to put a little more powder in there. That's all right. That's all right. We'll go with all that. All right. We're at the end. I appreciate you staying with me, watching this thing through at whatever speed you may have chosen. And I'm going to slow down on the videos some. You'll see some from home, but out on the road, I'm going to, you know, we'll see. That may last a few days. That may last a few weeks or even maybe, you know, we'll see. I'm kind of, tired of all that goes into making the videos and loading them in the truck and on the road. And at home's a different story. Thanks for joining me, and I will see you down the road.